Hey there, I'm Manuela with Plytix. Welcome back to the Plytix Academy syndication course. In the last lesson, we discussed the manual method of preparing product data for syndication and how to automate this with Plytix channels. We also showed you how, when you process a channel in Plytix, the system creates a feed URL. In this lesson, we'll show you how you can syndicate data using this product feed URL. But first, let me explain what that is. Simply put, a product feed URL is a URL address that contains product information in a defined file format. Feed URLs are a common and efficient method of syndication when it comes to e-commerce because they help you automate the syndication of data to platforms. How does this work? Well, many popular marketplaces and price comparison sites such as Facebook, Minto, WooCommerce, Google Shopping, and more accept feed URLs. These platforms are then able to fetch information from that feed without you needing to constantly upload files manually. But it doesn't stop there. Feed URLs are also useful when you need to provide product data to retailers or clients. This way, they can always have product data available without you needing to email files back and forth. Naturally, you still need to update the feed so that the platform retrieves the correct information. But Plytix takes care of that by automatically fetching the latest information from your account. So, the channel retrieves information from your account and stores it in the feed URL. And then the platform retrieves information from that feed and uses it to update your products accordingly. Ultimately, product feed URLs help you save time by setting up a link to your product data and automating updates on a regular basis. Let's look at how Plytix can take all the products, data, and assets that you have stored and package them into a tiny feed URL so you can syndicate data in just a few steps. As we showed you in the last lesson, it starts with creating a data feed with the Plytix Channels feature. Once you've processed your channel for the first time, you'll notice a link will appear below the channel name. That's your product feed URL. When you connect this feed URL to a platform that accepts it, Google Shopping, for example, then that platform can access the information in it to generate or update product listings for your store in bulk. To do that, you just copy and plug the resulting URL into, in this case, Google Merchant Center as your primary feed like this. That's it. The beauty of the syndication method is that you only need to add the feed link once. Once you create a feed URL, you can choose how often the feed is processed on Plytix's end so that the product information that you add, remove, or change in your Plytix account gets updated in your feed URL automatically. You can also adjust the settings in your seller account to read your feed URL and update your product information on a set schedule too. With this syndication method, your product listings will always reflect the most current version of products that you have to offer. Now, feed URLs work with more than just platforms. Remember earlier, I said you could also use feed URLs to send data to clients and partners. Let's say you have a partner who needs data in a spreadsheet format. Rather than you needing to email them that spreadsheet every so often, you can create a channel and send them the feed URL. They can then use that URL with something like Google Sheets to fetch and read the latest information from that URL. There's also a second option, which we'll talk about next lesson. So you can see that creating feed URLs through Plytix is a super convenient way to get your product information from point A to point B. But what if your sales channel doesn't accept feed URLs? Fortunately, even if that's the case, you still have options. You can use a plugin or channel partner to deliver your URL to certain platforms, or you can simply download the file from a feed URL, which we'll dive into in the next lesson. So remember to hit subscribe and hit that bell button to know exactly when the next video is out. See you next lesson.